I seriously need some better armor. I mean, just look at this. Look at this crap. Look at this. If what? Like, it's 23 durability. I have to replace this. I have to fix this. I just have to. I can't not fix this. This is ridiculous. This is getting out of hand. But first I realize is I'm gonna need some XP. And I did find a regular spider spawner a while ago. And I could just go get a spider farm. That would be pretty good. Yeah, let's do that. There we go. That gives... All right, buddy. That gives me immediate access to the ancient city. Okay, I need to get rid of that thunder. Jeez, what is going on up there? Jeez. I do not feel like making a gold farm. And I haven't gone to the end yet. And I don't have enough villagers to reliably get me experience. Actually, you know what? I just realized I should probably do this with a time lapse. Oh, there you go. Ton of them down there. They were very loud today. Wow, holy crap. I don't think it matters if it's slightly inefficient. Because this is a lot of spiders. You know, here, I can add some cobblestone in allusion to the original look of the place. That's actually pretty cool. I don't like that noise. I don't like that noise at all. No, sir. No, thank you. I'm just going to place a porch here, so it's obvious where I need to go. Wee. Oh, a little bit of iron. Ooh, a little bit of copper. Yeah. Well, that's the XP farm done. The XP farm I will probably only use for 30 more attacks, because that's the amount of attacks I have left on my sword. I asked on my community page whether you guys wanted me to build a windmill wheat farm over there-ish, or a iron forgery, which I never actually specified the location of, but it will be going somewhere about right here. And only 3 people responded, but the 3 people who did respond, 2 people voted iron forge and 1 person voted windmill. So, I guess we're building an iron forge. Oh, wait a minute. Never mind. I need to finish this place first. Never mind. I want the moss without the azalea. So let's just... And this is the iron forge. This is the work in progress design of the forge. This is the only thing wrong with it is that this middle piece would be taken down to 1 block, so it would actually be odd. But the only issue is that it does require a lot of stone. Stone that I do not have. Well, I have this stone. But this stone barely counts, okay? And I'm not just gonna go mine stone for the heck of it. And that means I need a cobblestone generator. Oh my gosh. Oh, I broke it. At least we know the concept works. How much stone did we get? Oh my gosh. We got a lot of stone just from that one little bit. Okay, fingers crossed. I have this fixed. All right, that worked. It's working. All right, I'm gonna sit here for 5 minutes and see how much cobblestone this gets. Oh my gosh. Oh my. Oh. Alright, and that should actually make the build much better, because adding leaves makes everything better. Yep. Yep. Adding leaves makes everything better. I'm telling you guys, if you're having trouble making a build fit in to an environment, just add leaves. Put leaves on it. Oh, look at this. Look, this guy has iron boots. Aw, you look so pretty with your iron boots. You're so fashionable. And now you're dead. You know what? That's not half bad. Yeah, I'm pretty happy with that. So I made some progress. A little bit of progress over the course of the last couple of real life days. I have built a new path up to the quarry and terraformed the side of it here with some moss and some leaves and stuff. And then you get up here, and there's the quarry right here. And then, didn't mean to do that, you have to go all the way down these stairs into this little cave area. And then you see this. You can either go down to the storage, or you can go straight to here. So this is the entire thing done, and if I just click this, it does work. I'm gonna back up a little bit. So we'll do damage to you. This is absolute insanity. So I've already also mined a bunch of this out. But before you take the time to watch me, you know, building this beautiful factory behind me, you should take the time to subscribe. Because this is a build that took me like 5 minutes. And you should appreciate it in all of its glory. So subscribe. Subscribe now. Subscribe. 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 And I've got the villagers I need. Hello, guys. How's it going? It is, I believe, dark outside, though. So that's probably, yep, not a good idea to do that now. Just have to steal a night of sleep from this man. And I've made some more visual changes mid-episode, like I usually do. I have a brand new aspect of my shader pack, which, as you can see in this totem, allows me to have these really bright luminescent thing. Oh, and here is iron golems. They're super shiny, super reflective. That basically goes with anything iron, including tools. And diamonds are pretty similar. Let me jump off a cliff here, and you can see it in my armor. It looks pretty darn good. And I changed the sun so that it looks kind of like that. All right, up here, buddy. And I have, in fact, finished the iron forge, at least the outside. I still need to do some work to the inside, but the outside's done. Oh, yeah, here's one of the new things I added. You can see it over there. I added a little minecart. I'm sorry, wait a minute. Are you not selling me iron? Are you not giving me an iron trade? This guy's not giving me an iron trade. My friend, this is the entire point of your existence. You will give me an iron trade. I guess I'm going to grab the other one. Give me iron. I am incredibly annoyed with both of you right now. Did you know that? Did you know that? Did you know that? And look, we have our beautiful several, actually basically two different sets of diamond armor. Thank you so much for your contributions. Both of you are worthless to me right now. I'm gonna need more villagers for the iron trade. Thorns 2, garbage. Respiration 3, not that bad. Protection 4, pretty good. Depth Strider 3, really good. Alright then, Protection 4. Alright then, Respiration 2, I should not have done that. Are they still making babies? Holy crap. I guess I gave them 5 stacks of potatoes, but I'm surprised how much progress these guys have made. Oh gosh, you guys are... Oh, you guys are making children amongst yourselves. Alright. Very loud, as always. You're those guys. Those are your brethren. And that's your protector. How's he doing as your protector now, huh? That was brutal, I'm sorry. Please give me an iron trade. Please, 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 please. Yes! Yes! Bonk. Bonk. Oh, I'm so happy you gave me that. Thank you. I very much appreciate it. Alright, buddy. Give me the good trade. Yes. Alright. Time to make a baby villager suffer. Gosh, darn it. Why do you keep killing them? Wait, he actually wore it. Okay. Cool. Whoa. Okay, you're okay, man. You're gonna love your new job. No. Frick you. The power of Prot 4. They do exist. This is one of my custom music discs, which will play at the end of the video. I actually, out of all the music discs I've gotten, I haven't gotten a single one of the custom ones until just now, which is kind of cool. I can give you a perfect little home, the perfect little job, and you're gonna be so happy. I'm gonna be so happy. Everyone's gonna be so happy. Oh my gosh, how did you... Out of 1 in a million chance that you hit this guy. How did you end up hitting that guy? What if I made my villager breeder a private school and you were the dean? You gotta whip those whippersnappers into shape, huh? Of villa private school, a very prestigious school, you know. Nice. Now you're a true dean of the school. This is also a very powerful zombie now. Like, if I... Yeah, he does have a heart even with full, almost full Prot 4. So you're a very powerful guy. And I have a better name than Zombifier 9001 now. Dean Branum. Dean Branum. Brainum. Dean Branum is officially named. This means I don't think I really have to deal with dead villagers anytime soon. You know, the previous dean, he wasn't very good at his job. Unfortunately, the private school is still a bit of a basement right now, but I think it'll be all right. Okay, and my armor, I think, is pretty much done. Not 100% done. There are a few things that could be improved, but things that I can improve when I get library and villagers. Stuff I'm not worried about right now. So let's take a look at what we've got. We've got the Diamond Helmet, Respiration 3, Protection 5, and Aqua Affinity. Pretty good. Protection 5? That's Protection 4. Protection 4, I'm breaking 3 chest plate. Bam. Protection 4, I'm breaking 3 leggings. The only upgrade I need to do to that is give it Swift Sneak 3. Protection 4, I'm breaking 3 and Depth Strider 3 boots. The only upgrade I need to do to that is give it Feather Falling 4. I also have a pretty decent diamond shovel. Just needs unbreaking. That just needs Silk Touch. That's pretty much perfect. Just needs a little bit more efficiency. And this is the God Sword. All it needs is one more level of sharpness. And it is basically done. It's the Sword of Subscription. Speaking of which, please subscribe. And it does 9.5 attack damage. Let's see what that translates to. All right, mobs, it's time for you guys to find out what discretionary spending does. Did he just shoot? He just shot the bat. How rude. Oh, he's setting on fire. How dare you? This is incredibly rude. Two and a half hearts. Acceptable. Acceptable margins. I cleared out my inventory just so I could break all this down and you could get a sense of scale of how many emeralds I have gathered over the past couple of days. This is an insane amount of emeralds, and no mortal should be in possession of this amount of emeralds. I know this is pathetic compared to some stuff that Hermitcraft does, but I am not Hermitcraft. So now the only task left today is to play the Song of Victory. Holy crap, that's really loud. Yes! Yeah! Haha, I'm so good at this game. You can probably not hear me, but please subscribe. I hope you enjoyed the episode. And oh, look, it's the minecart. Goodbye. Thank you so much for watching. Sorry the music's so loud. Have a good day. Alright, that is so loud. And okay, we're done.